Welcome to Simi's Cooking Connection. My name is Simba Ofora. I'm here to show you how to prepare a special meal called Fijo. This meal is prepared once a year in Nigeria on Good Friday, but feel free to cook it whenever you like. I hope you're as excited as I am to cook this meal. Come with me while we start cooking. These are the ingredients to cook Fijo with. Black eyed peas, which already been pre-soaked. Fresh fish, all clean and cut. All the spices, black pepper, thyme, minced garlic, crushed red pepper, chicken bouillon to give it taste, and onion powder. I love using sea salt because it differentiates it from sugar. And here is the oil. I prefer peanut oil, but due to allergy, you could use any oil you prefer. The next step is to cook the pre-soaked black eyed peas. For every cup of black eyed peas, I use 4 cups of water. And the best method is to cook your black eyed peas in a crock pot or medium heat for 1 hour and left overnight as to give it the firmness and tenderness needed. The next step is to blend the black eyed peas. But first of all, I'm going to blend the pepper to cook the fish with. Now I'm going to pour the blended pepper into a bowl. This goes in the bowl. I have to set it aside for the fish. My next step now is to get the bowl. Oh, here goes Shorty. That's what my kids call me. Oops. Here's the bowl for the fish. Now I have the stove on to cook the fish. First and foremost, I'm adding the oil. You don't want your fish too oily. That's enough. My next step is to add all the seasoning. First and foremost, I like to add the onions. My next thing is to add the green pepper, the red pepper. You add all that. Just toss it around in the oil. This pot is bigger, so I have to get this out of the way. There goes the crock pot. I'll lower the heat because we don't want all our veggies burning. My next step is just to add a little bit, a teaspoon of black pepper. I love thyme, so I'm adding 2 teaspoons of thyme. A full spoon of garlic, minced and chopped. I can smell that already. Onion powder. That's another thing. Oh, this gives it an added color because I already have the green pepper, the yellow pepper, the onions, which is plain, and there goes my crushed pepper. And hey, this is makes it so tasty. Chicken bouillon. I love chicken bouillon, don't you? I'm adding 2 teaspoons of that. The last but not the least, I'll just add a little bit of sea salt because sea salt seems to be so salty, you don't want to add too much of it. I'll leave it to individual to add it to it when it's done. Now we need to toss that. I get my red pepper, my blended pepper, sorry, I said red pepper. Blended pepper. I'm just eyeballing this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see. I need one more. 5. That's it. Can you see everything? If it Mmm, I love this. It smells so good. My next step now, I put this aside, is to add the fish. I've already seasoned, cleaned the fish with a little bit of salt. Take your time in adding the fish one at a time. By the way, this fish is called croaker. Croaker fish is not too bony, but it's very firm. It has some bones in there, you have just to be careful. But not little bones. Mmm, can you smell the fish already? I can. Whoa, I can't wait. This is what I look forward to every year on Good Friday. Now, with the fish, I'm going to turn it to the other side because only one side was cooked. You have to be very careful when you do this because you don't want all the fish going crumbling. I need a ladder or something to make me taller. Now I cover the fish, leave it there to simmer for 1 to 2 minutes, then it will be done. While that is steaming, I'm going to start by blending. Please come with me while I blend the black eyed peas.